a race that over the years has been perhaps subject to a little bit of criticism. Some people say that there are people who start their horses in this race and often they're not trying, only for the reason that they don't want to pick up weight for the second day. Well, with a $37,500 stake, that tends to be out the door these days, as most people are gracious to get any stake in a return. They have the opportunity now for the first leg of the double, and the field is a good one.
Number one is Rose and Thistle, two Bellerophon, three Greatness, four Mr. Duthie, five Rebel Royale, six Rhineguard, seven a secure deposit, eight Double Trouble, nine Gun for Fun, 10 Otakiri Maid, 13 Secret Ace, 14 Unequaled, 16 Rush Cutter, 17 Terra Nora, 20 Shigolvan, and 22 Katarichi.
No surprise that the favourite at the moment is Secret Ace, number 13, a five-year-old by Funny Fellow out of Malay's Pride, owned by Mr. Ash Daly, trained by Ray Johnson at Matamata, and to be ridden today by Peter Johnson. 13 Secret Ace on the tote, 480, 170.
No surprise, this horse is the favourite in the Queen Elizabeth. His form of late has been outstanding, beaten into second place by his very talented stablemate Colonial King at Pukekohe, then a very good third in the Avondale Cup. Number 13, Secret Ace, a top chance in the race.
Just in front there is the old veteran of the field, number 9, Gun for Fun, 10-year-old by Balios, owned by Mr. Kevin and Bill Myers of Hawera, trained by part owner Bill Myers and Debbie Healy to ride Gun for Fun. And I'm not absolutely sure, Grant, but I think this will be one of the few occasions that she's been with Gun for Fun.
Yes, I think so, Philip. He's showing 25 to win and 680 for a placed Gun for Fun. As you say, the veteran of the field at 10 years of age, keeps running very good races, was a little disappointing at his last start at Awapuni, but he ran a very good race at Trentham on December the 8th when he was second to Encore. And although he might be 10 years of age, I think I'm right in saying that he didn't have his first race until he was about five.
Typical of the Myers breed, they've tended to keep some of these good horses for jumpers. This fellow's proved a little bit too good on the flat to be put over the fences, and that's why he's there. Number 9, and that is Gun for Fun. Just edging in front there is number 17, Terra Nora. Quiet word for this horse around the course. David Peake is to ride him. Big, strong 5-year-old by Imperial Seal out of Donnacherie, owned by Mr. and Mrs. Jack Robbins of Tauranga. David Peake to ride, and on the tote, 17 is paying 10 and 320.
Well, you mentioned earlier, Philip, that there was some suggestion that a lot of horses were in the Queen Elizabeth just for a run, but when you look down the bottom of the weights, some of these horses need to gain weight to gain a start in the Auckland Cup, and this is one of them. Terra Nora, he needs a top effort today here to gain a run in the Auckland Cup, and his form of late has been very, very good indeed, and don't be at all surprised if he's right in the firing line at the end of this 2400 meter race.
Six scratchings in the field, which brings the quality or the quantity down to 16 starters, and they will begin at the 2400 metre point, which is the entrance to the front straight. Here is the visitor from Central Districts now, number 1 Rose and Thistle, Errol Skelton of Levin, is the trainer, Brian York to ride, recent racing in Australia, 22.660.
Well, yes, most of his recent racing has been in Australia, but he did run an excellent placing in the Melbourne Cup, and he did win a recent trial at Bulls, but really, with his big spell from racing, it's a bit hard to see him being a big threat over 2,400 metres. Has a proven record as a stayer, Rose and Thistle. He's going to start from wide on the track, which means that he'll either have to drop back or be used up to get handy, and so Rose and Thistle, perhaps slightly forlorn hope in this Queen Elizabeth.
There's number 4, Mr. Duthie, winner of the Waikato Gold Cup. Colin McColl of Tarapa, the trainer. Peter Timms, the rider. And on the tote, 18.590.
Yes, well, he won the Waikato Cup in most convincing fashion. In fact, had a very good field behind him that day. Then he disappointed somewhat by running 8th in the Avondale Cup. And like Rose and Thistle, he's drawn very wide indeed. But I think Mr. Duthie is pretty well seasoned, and he should be there or thereabouts.
Probably the sort of horse that would have appreciated a slight easing of the track. But that's to be proved. Rose and Thistle at odds of 22 to 1. Bellerophon at 38 to 1. Greatness quite supported at 7.30 a win. And there is young Ron McKenna. I'm sure he liked being called young. Ron McCann, a very experienced rider from the South Island. He will ride Rheingard, number 6, who is already in the stalls. This was the horse that almost caused the upset, I suppose, at Avondale.
Yes, ran second in the Avondale Cup. That was an excellent run, just beaten by a carrier. You remember that one of our televised meetings in November, he beat Commissionaire at Wait for Age at the New Zealand Cup meeting at Riccarton. Obviously a classy sort, Rheingard. He did open favourite here, but subsequently has lost that now to the Secret Ace. But Rheingard certainly will start second favourite in the race.
Warwick Robinson, who'll be aboard Chargolvin, number 20 in the book. Very classy mare and well-bred and liable to be in the firing line at the end. Debbie Healy aboard Gun for Fun.
Chargolvin there is going to start third favourite in the race at $7.10 and $2.50.
Young Shane Dye is aboard 16 Rush Cutter, given a good chance too in the event. And just waiting for the gentleman to adjust his goggles there and can't pick him up at the moment. Obviously doesn't like television because he's avoiding us. Gary Grills, who is riding in this event as well. And he's aboard 22 Qatari Chief. Peter Johnson aboard Secret Ace. David Peak goes forward with Terranora. And looking reasonably good now for a start in the race. Totalizator has closed. Often the winner of this race, or certainly the first three or four, feature prominently in the Auckland Cup. And that obviously has yet to be proved, but actually I was wrong there before, by the way, giving Warwick Robinson as the rider of Chargolvin. Lance O'Sullivan riding Chargolvin.
Sit quiet, boys. You've got the power.
Racing in the Queen Elizabeth. Mr. Duthie bounded out of the outside gate quickly with Greatness rushing over to get a posse early. Now on the inside, Double Trouble accelerates to lead them all. Racing up Secret Ace, the favourite's going to be handy as they settle. Drifting back, Otakiri Maid with Chargolvin. They are the last two as they race over to the rail now, and the pacemaker Double Trouble, and he's pulling his head off. And nobody wants that pace. Right there, secure deposit. Rose and Thistle trapped wide. Mr. Duthie dropping in a beautiful spot. Secret Ace. On the inside of it is Rheingard. A length and a half. Qatari Chief. One out. Greatness to unequaled as they go to the judge now. Two and a half behind them then is Rebel Royale. A half to Bellerophon. Then Terranora settling fifth last. With Otakiri Maid. Rush Cutter. Two back behind these. Gun for Fun and Chargolvin. They're about 15 lengths off the leaders as they work out of the straight now, and it's Double Trouble. Still well on the bit, leads a length now from Secure Deposit, and Rheingard gets the trail. A length back then is Secret Ace. On the outside of it, Rose and Thistle, Qatari Chief. Two back, Mr. Duthie in the clear. A length back then, Greatness, a half away, Rebel Royale. They're followed round then, unequaled from Bellerophon, then Terranora working round wide. Then followed by next, Rush Cutter, a length back, Otakiri Maid from Gun for Fun and Chargolvin. On the far side, 1,300 metres out in the Queen Elizabeth, and it's Double Trouble, the leader, leading one length from Secure Deposit. A half length back, Rheingard, the run of the race. Right there then is Secret Ace with then Qatari Chief. Working up Rose and Thistle on the outside, Mr. Duthie the Grey. A length back, Rebel Royale with Greatness on its outside as they work up the rise. Then followed unequal, there's Terranora three deep at that point from Rush Cutter, Bellerophon, a length and a half out of Curry Maid, Chargolvin and Gun for Fun last. Down the rise now, 900 metres to go, and the pacemaker Double Trouble, three parts from Secure Deposit going keenly. A length and a half, Rheingard, Secret Ace, one out and working round the two on the outside, Rose and Thistle. Greatness works round wide from Mr. Duthie, Qatari Chief, a length and a half, Terranora, then unequalled on the inside, Rebel Royale, the pace going on at the 600 metres. Then followed Bellerophon, Rush Cutter is well back with Chargolvin, Otakiri Maiden dropping away, Gun for Fun. 500 metres to go, and the leader is Double Trouble. Still here, Secure Deposit first to pounce. Coming out on the outside of the two, Rose and Thistle, looking for room. Secret Ace badly, and Greatness making his run down the outside and completely sneak it. Then is Rheingard and Qatari Chief. 250 to go, Secure Deposit. Greatness levelling on the outside with Rose and Thistle going a big race. Right in behind them, then Secret Ace, but it's Greatness in front of the 100 metres. Coming after him, Rose and Thistle hard on the inside. Greatness and Rose and Thistle. Rose and Thistle with his nose in front of him. He's won the money in the top weight. Second is Greatness. Third, Secure Deposit, Secret Ace, no room. Fourth, then followed Mr. Duthie, Rebel Royale. Otakiri Maid was next home. They were followed Terranora, well back behind these Qatari Chief. Then followed Double Trouble. In that group, Chargolvin, a long way back, Rush Cutter. Then followed Bellerophon, Gun for Fun, unequalled. And finishing well back was Rheingard, who had no...
Very good effort by Rose and Thistle and the Ideal. A DB Auckland Cup trial for the good horse from Errol Skelton's stable. He's shown that he's taken no harm from his racing in Australia. He's ready for action and a very good trial indeed. Let's have a look at the final stages of the race.
The leader at this stage is Double Trouble, just starting to weaken a wee bit. Coming out is a Secured Deposit. And just look for Rose and Thistle in behind them at the moment, looking for a way through. Greatness is starting to challenge on the outside. Now here's Rose and Thistle through the centre. Greatness on the outside, and Double Trouble is gone. Secured Deposit still there on the fence. Rose and Thistle and Greatness really starting to sort themselves out now. And Rose and Thistle just holding that neck advantage at the moment. Greatness trying hard. And Secured Deposit is still battling away down on the inside. Secret Ace starting to flash home along the rails. But Rose and Thistle, despite a lack of recent racing, has gone to the line almost a length clear of number three, which was Greatness, with Secured Deposit in third place. And it's Secret Ace who's flashing home into fourth. And that looks like a pretty good Auckland Cup trial from that horse as well.
So the call is 1-3-7. 13 and 4 take 4th and 5th in the race. Number 1, Rose and Thistle, 6-year-old by Harbour Prince out of Scotch Belle, trained by Errol Skelton of Levin, ridden today by Brian York. And a very good result for the connections of that horse, because it was the ideal trial for the Auckland Cup next Tuesday. Second placing, it would go to number 3, Greatness, 7, Secured Deposit. Well, he has to be the most improved horse, because that was a very, very good run. And I'm sure there'll be some thought now as to whether he must be a big chance in the big race next week.
Very good ride indeed by Brian York, and an excellent training effort from Errol Skelton, Philip, because that horse hasn't had a start back in New Zealand since campaigning in Australia. And all he had was a trial over 1200 metres, which is half this distance, and he's come out and won the Queen Elizabeth Handicap, and from a very wide barrier draw, so he had to be used up early to get a handy place.
Yes, the sort of horse that Errol has taken on many occasions through to Brisbane, raced over there, and has been to Ellerslie on a number of occasions. So confirmation of the placings we await now, but no doubt about it, 1 will get it, 3 will be second, 7 Secured Deposit will be third.
So Rose and Thistle, a most convincing winner of the Queen Elizabeth Handicap, and that very much belies the fact that some horses are only in it for a run, because Rose and Thistle was the top weight. And no doubt we'll now have to have a re-handicap for the Auckland Cup. That remains to be seen. Rose and Thistle has been a very well-performed horse over the years. It's a 6-year-old now by Harbour Prince out of Scotch Belle. Greatness, a horse who certainly caused some controversy in Australia when he was ruled out of racing by the BRC stewards, has run second, another good Auckland Cup trial. And Secured Deposit, who many people thought would be far better suited by the Trentham and the Wellington Cup meeting, has gone a very good race indeed in running third here in the Queen Elizabeth, and now it must be rated a big chance in the Auckland Cup.
I noticed too that the horses that finished fourth, fifth and in sixth place, all quite pleasing runs. Fourth was Secret Ace, number 4, Mr. Duthie. He was handy there for most of the journey. He stayed there and battled into fifth position, and number 5, being Rebel Royale, ended up in sixth position. Rheingard was a little disappointing. He seemed to be under pressure at the turn and then started to fade as the pressure was really applied. Well, dividends are available, so let's check them now for the Queen Elizabeth Handicap.
Pretty healthy dividends too. Number 1, Rose and Thistle, has paid $22.55.